Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Amber Living Vlog. This is Beyond Film School, and I am Amber, and today we're talking about how to handle booking gigs and the booking policy that a lot of freelancers use. So, hey everyone! I apologize for my voice. I feel like my voice is like an octave deeper, but I just got off two short films in a row, and I have a loud voice, and I feel like I have to do a lot of yelling as a first AD, so my voice is a little bit more raspy than normal, and I apologize. So let's talk about booking. Let's talk about freelancing and how to handle, you know, booking yourself and what booking policies people have. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you my policy first. This is what I do, and it's very simple. I stick with whoever booked me first. So I basically go off my calendar, and if I'm available or not, that is who I will go with or stay with. So it's very rare that I will drop a gig that I am booked with for another one for higher pay or for a higher position. I feel, and not everyone will agree with me, I feel that Your reputation is basically everything, especially in such a small community in the film industry, LA and New York. Like, you're only gonna run into so many people, and the more you work, you're gonna see the same people over and over again, and there's only so many producers, and there's only so many, you know, people, crew members, and everyone that needs to hire you. So if you start to gain a rep where, oh, this person will, you know, flake out on you for higher pay, no one likes that person. But at the same time, we all know we're trying to make a living, and we all know that we're all freelance and you got to pay your bills. So keep that in the back of your mind. I asked other people in other departments what they do, because me, I guess I just don't want to let anybody down. Once I commit to a project, you know, I will see it through. I don't like quitting things, and a lot of people don't agree with me. They're like, you know what, we're not going to see it through. I won't deal with bullshit. I won't deal with a different pay rate, or if another job comes that pays more, I'll take that job, and if another job comes where it's a higher position, I'll take that job. I just, you know, I don't see myself, I don't usually set myself up for taking second AD, second. I'm usually exclusively either a first AD on short and feature, or I'm a set PA on union shows. Those are the only times. So it gets kind of weird when I am asked by key PAs to be on set when I'm booked for short films. Sometimes, and this does happen, sometimes those union shows where I'm a set PA will pay more than when I'm a first AD on indie shoots. Now, I had this exact situation come up the other day where we had to reschedule one of our shoot days on the short film that I was doing and I was being a first AD on. And the reshoot day, the reschedule, because we had a snowstorm and we just couldn't, it would be crazy to shoot on a day where like 2 feet of snow is going to fall on the ground in the Tri-City area. So we rescheduled for that Monday instead of doing it that Thursday. And that Monday I was booked to be on the last day of Power. And I really wanted to do the last day because I really liked the people that worked there. And it was like, oh, you know, I would get to, you know, say goodbye to everybody and maybe hopefully see them next season and all that jazz. So I was like, yeah, I can't do the reschedule. I can't do the reshoot. I can't do the rescheduled day. And then I had to find a replacement AD, and all that's just so complicated. I had to send them all my prep work, I had to finish up all my prep work and finish all the call sheets and do so much work just to find this replacement that, you know, and then she got a feature that got rescheduled earlier. So she ended up not being able to do it. So I just was like, I took my odds. I was like, where am I gonna be happier? Where am I gonna be happier? Do I like being a first AD? Of course. Do I like being a set PA? Not always. I do like certain shows. I do prefer certain, you know, to work on certain shows, but as a whole, I feel like I'm happier in the first AD position, and it's night and day when you're a set PA versus when you're a first AD. So I had to cancel on Power, and I hated the fact that I had to do that, but in the end, it's like I committed to this project, and the producer, director, slash executive, or director, executive producer, writer, and then she started the movie. Like, I really needed to kind of stick by her. It was a really important project for her, and I felt like I had to stick with her, and I didn't want to throw in another AD in the whole process for her. So that was, I mean, I don't normally do that, but in this instance, I was like, yeah, I have to stay with where am I happier and who am I working with, because essentially, like, the short film that I did, that's going to be made into a feature, and the chances of her going with the other AD is a chance. It's a fear in my mind. I'm like, what if she likes the other AD better than me? What happens? She's going to hire her for the feature and not me. So that was like, you know, there was a little bit of like, I don't know what to do, but then, I mean, I really felt that, you know, I gotta stick with, you know, the whole project as a first AD. It's just more important for me to finish gigs as a first AD than finish, like, than a stupid set day on a TV show that I'm only a PA on. So, okay. So, I talk to people in camera, and I talk to people in the art department, and they say that, yeah, they will take a gig if it pays more. They will drop and they'll find a replacement. They'll be really polite about it too. It's like, what do, right? You, first of all, you can offer a replacement. You say, okay, I really, you know, I'm sorry, something came up, I have to do this thing, something was rescheduled, whatever fucking excuse you want to explain to the person you're canceling on, that's your business. Truth or not, whatever you decide to tell them, just be diplomatic about it and try not to burn the bridge, because that's the last thing you want. Don't burn the bridges, people. That's like the number one thing I can probably tell you in the industry. Just don't burn the bridge. So just be diplomatic about canceling on anybody. And then you'd be like, you know what? Have a replacement already on standby. Like, just go, you know what? I have this person there available, and they're awesome. They've worked with so-and-so before, and they're really, really great, and they'll be replacing me. Sometimes that will fly. Sometimes that won't, because some producers like to hire their own people, even if it's a camera person, or art PA, or art department, or set dressing, or whatever it is. So that's what they do. And I've also had them take higher position gigs for lower pay. If, say, like, she were the second assistant camera and then she got a gig for a short film as a DP. So obviously, if you're trying to do the DP thing and you need a reel, obviously you would take lower pay to make sure you are the DP on a short film. So it's really like a lot of different things you can do. It's based on what you want in your career, where you're happier on set, and, you know, it's just how you present why you're canceling on that person. Because just remember, every time you cancel on a person, it does create an amount of stress on that person, because now they have to refill that position. And then there's also that, oh my god, that person's going to flake out on me. So there is a chance that that person will never hire you. You can be as diplomatic as you want and try not to burn the bridge, but all in all, they could just be like, no, I'm not going to hire this person ever again because they canceled on me, which definitely does happen. So you're taking a risk. that's one thing I'm going to tell you. It's whatever policy works for you. Now, okay, we talked about, you know, rescheduling shoots. And I think that's the only time I get really, like, lenient in my canceling of gigs, because if it's a reschedule, you can't help that. If the shoot rescheduled, that's basically out of your control. So I feel like that's more forgiving than just, hey, I'm taking a gig for higher pay, or I'm taking a gig for just because it's a higher position. People can't do anything about, you know, rescheduling stuff. What I also want to talk about is family emergencies, last minute cancellations, and, you know, just the random bullshit, I'm gonna be late, okay? Now, before I don't even know if she watches my videos, and I really don't fucking care if she does, but let me just tell you, she definitely burned a bridge. You don't cancel. You do not do the bullshit where, oh my god, the weather, or this and that, okay? Let me tell you what ADs do on a shoot. ADs make sure the weather is like fucking, we know what's happening. We have the fucking apps with Doppler radar. We know when storms are coming in because weathers affect our shoot, okay? I know what's going on with the weather, and I really hate when people treat me as if I'm fucking stupid. So this is what happens. The morning of the shoot, she texts me at like 9 in the morning, and she says, hey, I'm coming from Philly. And I was like, wait a minute, you told me you were coming from fucking somewhere in New Jersey, and now you're coming from Philly. First of all, okay, you're lying. Or maybe the situation changed. I'll be a little forgiving. Maybe the situation changed. So she then tells me, the trains are really backed up because of the weather. Okay, the weather wasn't the fucking problem that day. It was a problem the night before, and it was totally clear. It was sunny, and everything was cleared out. And I was like, okay, you know, how late are you going to be? What's going on? She said, oh, she'll be late. This is what she started off with. She said she would be late. And then I was like, a couple hours later, I go back to sleep because we have a late call. I'm getting all the sleep I can if I have a late call. Fuck that shit. So then she says, a couple hours later, she said she'll, oh, well, before that, she said, okay, I'll keep you posted. So thanks. Just let me know what's going on, whatever. So at this point in the conversation, I'm like, okay, fine, you know, you could be late. I'm not like cutthroat AD where it's like, you know, I understand things come up. So I'm like, okay, I'll give her the benefit of the doubt. A couple hours later, I actually get up for the day to get to set. And then I was like, hey, you know what's going on? Let me know what's going on. What's happening with the trains, blah, blah, blah. And then I'm like, okay. I'm like getting ready and I'm like, let me just see what's happening on Google Maps. Let's just see. So I'm like, okay, Philly to New York. Google Map, there are like no delays. There's zero delays. She's giving me the bullshit, people. She's giving me the fucking bullshit. So she's telling me, she's like, yeah, I'll be a few hours late. I'll be late. I'm like, okay, first of all, you texted me at like 8 o'clock in the morning. Our call time is 2. You have like 6 hours to fucking get to set. I don't understand. She's like, oh, the trains are really, really backed up. And I was like, Just can you just be clear? Are you coming to set or are you not? Because I need to know if I have to find a replacement like right away. I ended up not finding a replacement because I was looking back and I'm like, you know what? Maybe I'll do okay with just the 3 PAs that I have. And I ended up giving more money to one of my stellar PAs. I gave him a $50 bump each day because she canceled. And I was like, I know that he's a good PA. He'll handle the pressure. And I gave him more money. I like pressed my producer. I was like, can we give him more money, please, Jesus? So I just hate when people give me the bullshit. And eventually she was like, yeah, I'm sorry, I'm not coming. I'm like, why couldn't you just tell me that at 8 o'clock in the morning? If you don't want to work on a fucking gig, just tell me. I'm not like, let me tell you, I hate having this whole like, do you need me? Do I need you? Yeah, I need PAs, but you're not the only PA. I try to help people. And the story is I met her in a store and then she found out I worked in the film industry and she gave me her info and said she wanted to be a set PA. So I was like, okay, I actually reached out to her. She did do one day on one of my short films like a year ago. So I was like, yeah, let me reach out to her, see what's going on. And just to give her another chance, give her more credits. And it was paid. It wasn't like I wasn't paying her. So I felt like I was doing her a favor. I was taking a risk on someone who wasn't that experienced because that's what I like to do. And just based on whether or not you're watching the show, like, or my, you know, my videos or whatever, you know that I'm trying to help people in their career. And that's what I want to do. So I give people chances. I just really hate when people take advantage of that or give me the bullshit. Like, just be straight up with me. I have no time for fucking bullshit. So if you want to do the last minute, like, oh, I can't make it, oh, the trains, the weather, at least make it a good fucking lie. I would believe family emergency more than I'd believe, yeah, the trains are backed up. I don't have internet, bitch. Like, I don't have internet. Come on. Like, let's be like, at least make the lie good. Like, there's no reason why you need to lie. Just say you want the gig or not. And I had booked her weeks and weeks in advance. It was, like, fucking ridiculous. So that's what I'm saying. Like, don't give people the business. Be straight up with everybody. And if you can't make it, you can't fucking make it. I don't care what the excuse is. Just tell me, oh, hey, I can't make it. I don't care. Like, just don't have me like, hey, okay, what's going on? What's going on? And this is why, like, communication is, like, so fucking... It's so important. It really is important, and people just don't get it. This is turning into, like, a super long video, but, my rant's over. So that is it for this week about, you know, double booking, canceling, you know, rescheduling, how to handle the whole gig freelance world. I hope this helps. Just keep in mind, you know, it's not always about the money. That, you know, do what is best for you and your career, basically, is probably the number one thing I can tell you. Integrity and will go a long way. Remember, it's about your reputation as well when you're working in the film industry. So just keep that in mind. And honesty, clear communication. It's priceless, people. It's priceless. So, oh, yeah. So, Facebook Facebook likes. I appreciate it. People have been liking my Facebook page. I really, really, really appreciate it because I was getting really lonely out there. So my Facebook page, Amber Living Vlog, please go there, like my page, see what's happening. I post some things. I love posting movie set memes. It's like one of my favorite things to post. You'll get updates on what's happening with me. And also, I am still doing production resume review. If you have a resume that you want me to personally review and critique for you, you get one round of free notes from me, and I've been doing that for a while now, and I really am impressed with some people's resumes. Like, some of the designs I've seen have been like really, really good. I also have the PA training course is still happening. I'm still working on my course outline, so if you want to be put on the mailing list to make sure you get info and details, those links are below. So comment below, like this video if you found it useful, like my Facebook page, and also I do have a Beyond Film School Instagram account now, exclusively for just everything film, so when I'm on set, you'll know it. You'll have all kinds of on-set stuff, so follow me on Instagram, and yeah, so that is it for this week, and I shall see you guys next time.